The time is exactly 8:08, and it's time to head out into the land of magic and mysteries. All right. We're traveling on the countryside of Danemark. Danemark means the land of the Danes, the land of the Dana givers, those who perform sacrifice and give in charity. Those are the good guys, the ancient guys who built things that lasted for thousands of years. Not some humbug, hippie, modern stuff made of concrete and iron that still breaks down in 100 years or in 10 years or in 9 or 11 years, who cares? So, going to break down. Anicca Bhata Sankara. The Buddha said, Anicca Bhata Sankara. Sarva samskara manityam. All the samskaras, or all the composite particles, all the composite phenomena, they are subject to dissolution. And that is the theme of the day. And we dance around with the horsey horses in the land of the dragons. The dragons are at the median between the sun and the moon in the phenomenal world. They are guarding the secrets of the tree of life. With furious anger, who dares to enter the lair of the dragons cannot be a vegan. And upper as far as it goes to make sure that all of his lunacy comes to an end. Elverhoy, Elverhoy, Elverkong, the mound of the elves, the stupa of the great elf Buddha that came from planet Meta and made something out of metal and something out of wood and something out of fire and something out of water and something out of ether and something out of hither and thither, and the zenith and the nadir, whichever was which, I always forget because my paraphernalia keeps falling off. So we go up the hill, beat the little tree, up and up the hill, up and up the ancient hill, up and up the dragon hill, riding the ancient winds, facing the ancient storms, meeting the Viking dragon, meeting the ancient lords, meeting the ancient lords. Go there, Wodin, that is the sound of the dragon, and that is the veil of the dragon, and that is the tail of the dragon. I'll take a break here and calibrate. All right then, we're back out from the ancient tree, and our dragon paraphernalia is about calibrated. Guess what? Today I'm hiding behind double black. I got the pair of shades, and I got the super veil that the Miss Windy blew in the thunderstorm to me last night when I was out with the dog and the cat singing for the half moon in the ancient grove. There's a grove with a mound that was dug away called LMAO, and it is the place where they would sacrifice in the ancient day and they would butcher in the medieval day. And now it's just an empty hall with no one to sing about the old spirits but some bombs and G and the dragons that are dancing with the ancient wind. Here we have a nice little mound. Mounds like this, the Buddhists call them stupa, and Jesus called it Golgata, the skull mountain. And similarly, the Bengali Hindus, they go to Kolkata to Kalima and the Bada Boom Jagya, they just chop off heads from all kinds of creatures. The story goes that in the days of Jada Bharata and the rest, they would also do human sacrifices, but now they're mostly offering goats and sheep and other kinds of helpless creatures, just like themselves. I wonder when the tables turn, because the word mangsa means me and him or her. So when you eat me, then I eat you, and on merry-go-round. We go on the humming top and the humming bottom as long as the humans want to come along. And whenever the mirror against the mirror becomes a boring game, then you can go and talk with the dragons and see what is the baggage that you are dragging on through the cabbage yard, and what is the air that lets you fly through the sky. So that's a simple thing. But meanwhile, why don't you go and think about that, and I'm preparing a meal for the ancient dragons that I'm going to actually eat myself, because the ancient dragons are already fed up with all of this stuff. Thank you. Take a break. We'll take a look at the magic bag of mysteries in a short moment. You just have to triangulate, right? Something like this. It's a good symbol to look at. A good place to be. Kapla, say the Klingon, today is a good day to die. Howdy. So then, we're back under the tree here. And guess what? Al Sufiyani uncle is going to tell what's in that brown terrorist nibiru bibiru bang of yours and the bang of mine. Let's see. Bag. All kinds of terrifying things may come out. This is called a zucchini for 5 till boots bar. Discount stuff. This is called the spar revet red cheddar ost. Torn red cheddar cheese. Real fatty, real cheesy American hamburger stuff. Then we got here a bottle of green sport liquid. Then we got here a matching bottle of green red sport liquid to match. Then we have a lamp with a broken pan. And here you just can't go to a dragon and give him some hippie rabbit shit. You have to have some salmon at least, and if you need to make someone shut up, take that. So we have actually an extra pair of gloves too, in case something else wants to be crazy. And we have a black bag of all kinds of terrorist material. We cannot really, I'll try to show what's in there. It's really hard to see because it's so dark in that bag. Anyway, well, we'll see with the lamp later on. So then, so what do we do next? Next, we put the leather gloves away, put the lamp away, cheddar cheese away, we put the tape away, we put zucchini away, we put the green liquid here, red liquid here, and we put the salmon in between. So that's about the right and true order of things. What are we going to do next? We're going to go looking for a sacrificial knife. Please stay tuned. The same bad channel, the same bad time. All bad here. Oh, no, 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 no,